And by fixed pie logic, I mean the idea that what matters more than the size of a pie is how many slices all the pie eaters get. So taking that to, you know, economic phenomenon, social phenomenon more broadly, the point is that interactions between social agents given the right institutional environment can yield mutually beneficial outcomes. They can be rooted in mutual exchange between two parties that benefit from the exchange because they value what they give up less than what they're getting and vice versa. And so in that sense, the wealth of both parties in the exchange have been increased. The pie has increased in size. They've not merely gotten another slice or anything, but the actual pie has increased. And this belief in the viability of mutual exchange, the possibility of it at all, and also the possibility of it being widespread and a defining feature of human society, that tendency, I think, is fairly critical to liberalism as it has existed, and you probably find something like that in a lot of the good liberals that we can learn from historically. And you know, going back to Jason, I guess, Jason Bias, his article, Radical Liberalism, The Soul of Libertarianism on Z4SS, makes the case that this kind of belief in mutual exchange and this understanding of that so-called fixed pie logic and why it's so dangerous, that is kind of the uniting feature of liberals in a lot of ways. And I think that's a huge, really critical component of my worldview and my political philosophy and my moral philosophy. You know, it's not just anarchist or left libertarian in its significance, that insight into the viability of mutual exchange, but it's also deeply connected to the Aristotelian philosophical outlook, which understands humans as having harmonious interests. Not that we never disagree or conflict in the real world, but that by resolving such conflicts and coming to agreements, we bring our interests closer into harmony and coordinate our plans with each other. And so I think in principle, there is a harmony of interests among all rational agents, because otherwise it's hard to make sense of something like universal justice. This is kind of related to the insight that it's better to be the subject of an injustice than to commit injustice, from old Socrates. But I guess my point is just that insight into the viability of mutual exchange really goes, it runs deep in the worldview. I find really compelling. We've gone as deep as, you know, these complex discussions about morality and justice, but we started with, you know, a topical news issue with unemployment numbers. So, you know, if anything, that illustrates kind of how wide-ranging I think that issue tends to be.